Next, we're going to define certain types of elements. Some of the elements in the set might hold special properties. And the first one we're going to look at is the identity element. Identity element. So the identity element is going to be an element of a set. Let's make our set. Our set is the set of all elements X. We have a binary operation. Let's say a binary operation, and a binary operation is just a little generic one that we're used to now, just a little x, and we're going to have an element, just an arbitrary element, let's make it x sub 1, is an element of x, and we are going to say that we now have this identity element, we're going to call this identity element u as an element of x if the following property holds. If I take u, and now my binary operation with x1, and that commutes, so it's got a commute as well, x1 and u, and I just get back x1. So no matter what element I take, some arbitrary element, if the binary operation under this commutative type of binary operation, if I have this, they're equal to each other, and I just get back my original element. If this holds, then this u, which is an element of x, is a binary, is an identity element, a special element in my set. And if it exists, it's actually unique, and we're going to look at the proof of that. So let's look at an example. Let's look at the set of, say for instance, let's say the set of integers. If I look at the set of integers, so 0 is in there, and I look at my binary operation of addition. So I'm looking at my set of integers under addition. So my set of integers under addition, I have this unique identity element, and that is the element 0, because I can take any element inside of z, let's make it z1. If I add to that 0, that's the same as just adding 0 to that element, and I get back that element. If I look at the integers under multiplication, so let's look at the integers under multiplication. And then my identity element, of course, is going to be 1, because z sub 1 times 1 equals 1 times z sub 1, and I just get z sub 1 back. So that would be a special type of identity element, but it is on a set under some binary operation, with this binary operation must have this commutative property. That's how we define it. And I claim that if it exists, it is unique. It doesn't always exist in a set, but if it exists, this identity element, then it is unique. How would we go about such proof? I think you can guess we're going to do proof by contradiction. So let's assume to the contrary. That the identity element, is not unique. It's not unique. Therefore, under this assumption, let there be at least two of them. So let P1 and P2 be identity elements of some set. Let's make it some set P. Of some set P under some binary operation. Now, we've just defined a few things. As humans, we've decided that's how we're going to define it. So if my identity element is P1, I'm choosing, because it's not unique, I can choose any one of them, and I have this binary operation with P2, that means I've got to get P2, because that's how we defined identity elements, and we've defined this binary, how we defined this identity element before. So I have to get that. But if I choose P2 as my identity element, then I'm going to get, well, that should be 1. If I use P, so in this instance P1, now this instance of P2 is my identity element, I'm going to get P1 back. So in other words, I have here P1 equals P1, this binary operation P2, and that's P2. In other words, P2 equals P1. That is in contradiction to my initial assumption. My initial assumption is therefore false. Therefore, I have to say that the identity element, if it exists, it is unique. So a nice proof of this uniqueness of an identity element if it exists.